Do you hit record again?
Yeah. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to T3G. My name is Fullthrottle.
And I'm Cerebro.
And today we're doing our roundup, weekly roundup of the TV shows. And do we have a... No, that's this week? Next week? Extra one? No?
Yeah. The extra is going to be next week.
We're going to talk about
Walking Dead next week. Even though it came out yesterday, we're filming this a little late. It's been a busy weekend,
and plus on top of that, it's on a Sunday, so we would have to watch it Sunday night.
And then record it. It's going to be...
Yeah, so it'll be the next week. So it'll be Sunday through Saturday.
Right after I turn down Destiny back here.
Right.
Oh, that's not going to work.
That's not going to work.
Where's the actual remote?
So yeah, today we are covering, what are we doing? We're doing Constantine, Gotham, we got Flash, Arrow, and Agent Carter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was a full week,
that's right. So, which one do you want to start out with?
Let's start with Agent Carter. We never talk about Agent Carter first.
Let's do it, because last time I even forgot about Agent Carter. I wanted to end the last one.
So let's talk about Agent Carter.
Let me start out Agent Carter.
Go for it.
I was excited. I watched this and I enjoyed it. What happened?
Good.
I think the reason I enjoyed it, one, she told them to shut the hell up. She basically told them who Boss was. I enjoyed that.
That was fun.
That was great. She showed them what's up and how low they are under her. So I thought that was cool. Them going to Russia?
Yeah.
Russia? So that was cool. Seeing a new atmosphere and having them go out, meet up with the guys from the movie.
Yeah, the Howling Commandos. Awesome. That was awesome. I'm glad they got the whole cast.
That was great.
That was fantastic.
That was great. Good job. It was just a very, very entertaining, watching her be this kind of a bad... See, I don't think I like her doing all her martial arts moves. I don't think it just looks good. But when she was, like, kicking ass with the gun and shooting down some guys, I thought that was more fun for her. It seemed more of a badass, more appropriate. She just seemed more of a badass. I could take that more, accept that better than her doing some martial arts.
Okay.
But overall, I enjoyed the episode. I there's really not much. I'm glad they're getting closer to see that, you know, I like the fact that her main captain, chief, whatever he is realizing that Stark might not be the bad guy
here.
So I like that aspect of it too. I mean, just overall, it was a very, very good episode.
I don't like the fact that Sousa, so I think Sousa's going to try to like out her as a spy or something. I think he's going to try to out her as a double agent.
Yeah, that's the only thing.
Sousa's like on her case and he's on her trail, but I don't think he doesn't understand. So he's just following his gut, which is obviously, you know, that's kind of his thing. That's what he's got to do, but I think it's just going to lead him into a confrontation that's going to end poorly.
Well, they do show a preview, and they do show that he tells her to freeze and that she's under arrest in the preview for the next episode. So, I mean, that part of it, I was kind of annoyed because, I mean, he knows her. Let's be serious. He knows her. He's obviously, he likes her, too. So for him to, like, second-guess her that easily, like, there's got to be a story behind it, right? There's got to be a reason why she did what she did. So why not ask her? Why not confront her personally?
But the thing about that is you got to realize the late 40s were a time when this fear of the Reds was huge.
I guess, yeah, that's true.
You know, so that's when the Cold War started brewing.
Right.
So to have this person who might be working for someone who's accused of selling weapons to the enemy, that's where it's kind of having that issue.
Right. No, absolutely. But yeah, overall, man, there's really nothing much that I can say that I did not like from this episode. It was just
I like the fact that they fleshed out Dottie. Well, not directly, but they definitely fleshed out the idea of how Dottie became, you know, crazy with the kicks and the jumps.
Oh, the girl. I thought that was really cool that they were showing that.
It was interesting to see kind of the beginning of that with the young girl at the place. That was kind of crazy. So that's kind of one of those things.
Like, she ended up killing her best friend. That was crazy.
Yeah.
That was great. But I loved it. Like, the fact that they showed that, I was like, good job. Good job, Marvel.
That was rough,
that,
man.
DC has been doing, like we see on Arrow all the time, murder, and they don't hold back. So it was this included kids too, which was even crazier. So for me to, I mean, I guess maybe I have a murderous.
You got a murder fetish?
I guess I got a murder fetish or something.
I have to keep an eye on this kid.
But, because it was just, it was a good episode. Like, they showed that. That was really, really interesting right off the bat. You know, that's what she went through. That's what she became. You know, seeing Agent Carter prove them and be like, you're nothing. Like, this is how much better I am.
Yeah, when they walk in and they're like, he's like, who are you? Who are you? Where's Peggy? That was great. He's like, I'm the guy in charge. And he's like, where's Peggy? I don't care who you are. Where's right? Peggy? I was like, oh, yes. Oh, he's going to be put in his place.
It's good. It's just overall, it was a great very, episode. Very cool episode. I enjoyed it. I'm glad they're getting back on the track of, like, one, showing that Stark might be innocent. Like, it's about time, and they did a good job with that. And I can't wait to see more. Obviously, the next episode is going to be now revolving around if she's a traitor or not, basically.
Right.
But overall, it's just a very, very fun episode. I was very happy with it.
That's six? I think we only got a couple more.
Only a few more. There can't be much more left. Because when does Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. return? Because I saw the trailer or something like that. I saw the trailer. They just did a trailer.
Looks good.
Yeah.
Looks good. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, so overall, I'm very happy with it. I don't know, you...
Yeah, no, it was a great episode. It was definitely a great episode.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. I mean, it really worked. It really worked, and I hope to see more of this from Marvel, because this
absolutely
is what they need.
I hope these last few episodes really ramp up, because I would like them, by the end of this miniseries, to be at the point of, like, at the point of the one shot where Stark calls her and says,
yeah, absolutely,
we're gonna go run
that would
Shield.
Make sense. Absolutely. That
so
would definitely make
that's,
sense.
That's what I want. So I hope it kind of ramps up very quickly. I mean, we've only got a few episodes left, so it has to.
It has to, and there's no doubt about it. Just
unless they're gonna leave us with a cliffhanger, which I won't be happy about, but
I hope they don't, because it wouldn't make sense.
It wouldn't, especially since it wasn't guaranteed to be a next thing.
It's a mini series, there's no reason for them to do that, so I hope they just get it all done right. But I hope the continuous episodes for this show and also Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. continues this route where it's an attention grabber. You know, like, I'm not saying kill every show, every episode, there's got to be a murder. But to show something like that on a Marvel TV show, that's going to be your, like, you have to go to those extremes.
Sure.
Not necessarily that route, but to those extremes to get that attention and grab that attention. Then from there, you're golden. Then you just continue off. So, and I don't see why Marvel couldn't do that. I mean, they're Marvel. They've done phenomenally with their movies. There's no reason why they can't do it with the TV shows. So,
absolutely.
So far, yeah, I have nothing much else to say about Agent Carter.
Yeah,
except
it was great.
Except good job, Marvel.
Absolutely.
Good job.
Absolutely.
What do you want to go for next?
Gotham.
Yeah, talk about Gotham. Yeah. So that's about it for Gotham.
It just really felt like it dragged out. Like, here's the thing. Obviously, they're not going to kill off Penguin, but they had this really dragged out thing about, like, Maroni might kill him. He's trying to, like, and I'm like, he's not going to kill him.
I like this. One, let me put it this way. Maroni showing, like, he can't be goofed again, that was awesome. That was good. I accepted it because Penguin tried his hardest to convince him why not to do it, why not to crush it.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, would you just shut up and take it like a man? It was great. I love that part of it. That was awesome. Fish, I really hope she's gone. Obviously, that guy that's in there, she knows him. They're going to be probably like making out in the next scene where they like grab each other instead of fight each other.
Right.
So clearly she knows that guy. So I'm not really worried about that. But I hope at some point she disappears. I like the fact that he pointed out Gordon, when Gordon was talking with Bruce, he pointed out you've been gone. And Bruce is like, yeah, I was in like out of the country or something like that. That's cool. You need to fade out Bruce, because if you continue to leave Bruce in here, the show will not be what you want it to be.
I think they did that with this episode.
They did.
Because he said, I'm releasing you from your promise.
That means
Gotham doesn't have to do
anything more
with the Wayne murders.
Yeah, absolutely.
At the end of this season, Bruce goes off onto his search.
Because he said, I'm going to do it. I'm going to take care of it. And then Alfred's like, when he makes up his mind. You can absolutely leave it at that and now just go from there.
There's realistically not even a reason to have him on the show anymore. Yeah. And you could easily just have a scene where Gordon picks up the paper and it's like, Bruce Wayne leaves the country.
Absolutely.
That's it. That's the last we see here. You don't
need anything else. You don't need any. This is not a story about Bruce Wayne. This is a story about Gotham.
If this continues into season two, which I don't know. It's tough to say. I don't even know if I wanted to. It's been kind of declining for me.
If they can end it in season one, I'd be happy with it.
But there's really nothing to end. Like,
no, I mean, just give me something good. Give me a good ending. Give me a good. Yeah. Give me a good finale.
Yeah, something good. Something finale. maybe Barbara comes back. He finds out that, you know, she's kind of a whore and an awful human being.
I hope she doesn't even come back. I hope he just gives up. He's got the doctor.
I would love for this to be a completely different, like, have very little to do with Batman Mythos.
Right.
Because right now, I like the fact that they...
Oh, did you see... Well, here's my question. Did you see the preview for the next episode?
No.
Okay, so the kid is Scarecrow, and they're going to actually bring it in. They're going to show Scarecrow become Scarecrow.
All right.
In the next episode. That's kind of what
I said. So he's 17 and a Scarecrow already?
Yeah. So here's the thing, I like
the idea of that until you just said that. I didn't see the preview.
Here's the thing. Apparently the adrenal glands, the dad's taking them and he's like creating them a liquid and he's going to put it into his son. That's what they show.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's Gotham. That's... No, listen, here's the thing. I'm perfectly fine with Penguin being in the series only because, to me, Penguin being 15 years older than Batman makes sense. It just, I've always seen Penguin as an older character.
Sure.
So that's fine. And I enjoy Penguin in this series. For them to have Nygma in here, to me, it's fun that they do little riddles and all that stuff. I actually enjoy that, but it doesn't make sense why he's here. He shouldn't be here.
He doesn't... Okay, so
and
he doesn't...
And then now bringing in Scarecrow, it makes no
sense.
Granted,
he's young,
but
he's like...
17.
But here's the thing. The whole thing about Scarecrow is that he's supposed to become a doctor. He's supposed to be a psychologist.
Right.
That's how he comes into this this whole thing. So, for him to just be the son of a madman, I don't know. I think they're really grasping at straws to try to make this a really exciting show. Where I think you have plenty to work with, but they're just not really working.
And that's what I just wanted to say. I think they're worried that they don't have enough to work with, and so they're using Batman characters.
Right.
And I'd be fine
if they went a completely different route. If they just made this their own thing and just used characters that exist in the Batman universe at various timelines.
Right.
I'd be fine with that.
Right.
I'd be perfectly fine with that. If they just said, we're just going to roll the dice, call it whatever comes up. That's fine, because then you could have 15-year-old Scarecrow.
Yeah.
25-year-old Scarecrow.
Sure.
You know, at when Batman's 10, 12.
I mean, listen, here's the thing. I enjoy the kid that plays Bruce. I just want to put this out there. All the actors, to me, are doing a phenomenal job. The guy that's playing Alfred does a great job. The kid that plays Bruce is doing a great job. Jim Gordon, actor, is doing a great job. Like I said, he did have that one episode where he was doing a little too much with the facial expressions.
Yeah.
And it just felt like over the top. But overall, he's doing a good job. And I enjoy the actor. He's been in so many things, and I can't remember his name, that plays Harvey, his partner. That guy's been in so many different things, and I've never not liked him in anything. So him playing as Harvey and playing this crooked kind of cop, he does a great job.
Right.
Just overall,
I like the fact that the police force is trying to turn around.
Yeah.
I like the fact that the lieutenant's on their side. It's going in the right direction. Because here's the thing: by the time Batman time proper,
right.
The police force is, for all intents and purposes,
a better police force.
A better
there's
police
crooked
force.
Cops,
there's
but
a couple,
not that
yeah,
many.
There's a couple here and there, but it's not that, you know.
Not
it's
the not, whole police
like, right
force.
Now, you have a couple people that are good,
and the rest of
they're
police
afraid
force,
to, they're
right.
afraid to work within, you know, they're afraid to work against the system that exists, because the system that exists
right.
is corrupt. So, you know, I'm glad to see that kind of forward motion on that. But it's one of those things that I really want them to, if they're going to just do this whole, their own thing, which is fine.
Sure.
Own it. At least own it.
Yeah.
Don't bring Barbara back. I don't want her back.
No, don't bring Barbara back. Keep Bruce out of it.
Because then, fine. You want to go this route and I don't care if they bring Bruce in. But if they got to do it their own way. So you're going to say you're going to say that Bruce Wayne is into this and he's looking for the killer. Bruce Wayne needs to find the killer.
Yeah.
Because I'm sorry, he's putting in this much effort,
and we need
this
to see
much money.
We need to see a mage. We need
he's
to,
got
to
age.
He's gonna. It's gonna be different actors playing. I mean, not necessarily.
I think they should do 5-year breaks. Because I think all the grown up actors can. As you age, you don't change very much.
Right, right.
But kids do.
Yeah.
In 1 year, he's not going to look very much different.
True.
But if you say in 5 years, you get a 18-year-old.
Yeah. So you mean you're saying like basically
season two is 5 years later.
Makes sense. I'm okay with that.
That'd be awesome for me because then you can say, all right, then you've got to fill in the little plot holes.
Right.
You're going to say, oh, this is what's been missing.
So then you're bringing in Bruce more often.
Yeah, you can say Bruce is now, he's grown up.
I'm okay with that.
He's running the industries.
I'm okay with that, but they need to go with that route because whatever they're doing right now is just, they're really just trying to pull things out from left and right just to figure out how to make it work.
Yeah, they're really just trying to slapping these characters in. You know, they had this whole Maroney thing in this episode, and a little bit of this police thing in this episode.
Right.
Just work with that.
Yeah.
If they could have fleshed out a little bit more, I feel like Nigma's, I want to call her his girlfriend, but
yeah,
whatever she is.
Whatever she is, crush, girlfriend, yeah, whatever.
I feel like they're going to try to play her like Harley.
And I hope they don't, because I wouldn't like it.
I wouldn't necessarily like it either, but I think that's the way they're going to go. I think they're going to play her like Harley.
Probably because
I think he's going to snap at some point. Maybe not snap, but I think he's going to find more excitement into, you know, giving people challenges.
Right.
And I feel like she's going to follow him. Because now she's gotten a little soft for him with that last little flirtation, like, you owe me a pencil.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that was totally, like, shit, there was no need to say anything else.
Yeah.
But she did, which was an opening.
Right.
So I think that's gonna grow, and I think she's gonna be his like little sidekick.
Sure,
because I don't think they're gonna. I don't think they're ever gonna use Joker.
The thing is
they should, but I don't think they're gonna.
They should. I mean, if they're just gonna go this route, there's no reason why not. I mean, that's the problem. But they won't. I don't think they will. And I think, honestly, I just don't want to talk anymore about the future. I just want to see where it goes. When it comes down to the episode overall, it was an okay episode. It wasn't terrible, but it wasn't great. The other DC shows are way better.
Absolutely.
So
let's talk about those.
Yeah, let's talk about it. So I want to talk about, let's say Flash, because I really just want to get to Flash. For me, the whole episode was great. But just that little one minute clip at the end, them showing Grodd, He lost my mind. He messages me at some random hour in the night.
He's like, Gorilla Grodd!
The reason I'm excited is to see that on screen. That's why I'm excited. To see it. When that episode happens, when he's fighting a gorilla, a giant gorilla, I think that's what the excitement is.
Well, that's
about.
The thing. The great thing about it is that Grodd is not a physical fighter. Grodd is a telepath.
Sure, absolutely.
So Grodd is going to be having other people go in his way, and that's going to be a great episode, hopefully.
Right, absolutely. But that's what I'm waiting for. Like, that's why I got excited. Because when I saw it, I got excited to see
it. I really like the fact that they just flat out said that Stein and Robbie connect.
Yeah, absolutely. That would, like, they just straight up, like, look, watch, here comes Robbie. Like, it was that simple. And now that's why he looks like Robbie, but it's not Robbie. And we're going to see him in the next episode.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to see him, actually. So that's...
You keep calling him Robbie. We mean Ronnie. Robbie's his name.
Robbie's
his actual name.
Playing Ronnie.
Yeah, it's hard to keep track of. Ronnie and Stein coming... Like, you know, Ronnie Raymond and Professor Stein made Firestorm in the comics.
Yeah.
That was the whole thing, is that they combine to become Firestorm and have these powers. Apart, they're nothing. They're just people. When they combine, they have these powers. So I'm hoping maybe somehow they'll find a way for them to separate. They'll have some sort of like, oh, we're going to fix you, we're going to cure you.
Right.
And they're going to separate them, and then somehow they'll be brought back together, and they're going to realize that they can use these powers to help you.
Yeah. Absolutely. No, I completely...
Because right now, he doesn't want to be found. He doesn't... Because I presume he feels like a freak of nature. Well, he's got voices in his head, and there's a whole lot going on.
Well, once again, from the preview for the next episode, you see him fighting Flash, and then in another scene that they show, you see them talking to him, and they're like, Ronnie? Oh, wait. No, you're not Ronnie, but, you know, that's tough to keep track of. That's what they say.
Right.
And it's cool. So it's interesting. So it looks like there will be a little conflict at first.
Sure.
And then he's gonna maybe maybe it's before or after, but at some point he mellows down to the point where he's sitting with them at the lab trying to figure things out.
Right.
So I'm excited. I can't wait to see that. But I'm glad they showed that in this episode, showing how that part works. Sure. Looks like they're trying to keep to the original where they are two people combined. Obviously, not 100% on probably how it happened. But I don't know the story. I haven't read the comics, so I can't say for sure. But at least they're keeping to that.
And
wait.
One day we'll have a studio.
That's
not next to a street.
Right?
At least not on Main Street. Yeah.
On Main Street.
So, the bit...
Jesus! That's the longest one ever. All right.
So, I liked the little kind of background, like, villain. It wasn't even... That, to me, wasn't even the main
the
story.
The girl, the teleportation.
Yeah.
I thought it was cool.
I don't know who she's supposed to be.
It reminded me a lot of Nightcrawler, because she needed to see where she needed to teleport, and that was one of Nightcrawler's things, was he needed to visually see
right.
where he would teleport, or know, or see it in his mind, so he needs to see it at least once. So it was cool, but at the same time, the whole time, I was like, well, it's a female Nightcrawler, but...
I don't know who she's supposed to be.
I don't either. But I thought it was a fun episode. I thought that was fun.
I like the fact that Piper got away.
Yeah.
I still don't like the fact that he's smart. Like, I really don't. Like, Piper to me has always been kind of the...
Not so smart kid.
He's just kind of been like the random dude. And
right.
he's just always like, he's there, but he's not really formidable. But this guy is intelligent, so he manipulated this whole situation where he did give them he did give Cisco what he wanted, but at the same time he got away. So,
true.
It was one of those things like he's too good at this point for me, and I hope something brings him down a notch, or you know, gives them an advantage over him.
Well, the thing for me was DC kind of, or CW or whoever you want to call. They played a little with my emotions this episode on that part, because I was waiting for Piper to escape,
sure.
right? And then Cisco kicks his butt and brings out the sand, and I was like, yes, he's not going to escape.
Yeah.
They're not going to go that route. That's awesome. Finally seeing Cisco not be a little punk, and then he escapes anyways at the end. And I was like, I kind of would have liked it better if they just had Cisco be the badass this time around and not let him escape.
Right.
So, because I'm like, come on. Really? The same trick worked again? He pulled out the freaking, the thing out of his ear, like, again? Again it worked? Come on. It would have been, I think to me, that part of the episode... I guess that would be my only gripe of the episode, even though I enjoyed the whole episode still, is that the Piper escaped and Cisco still looked like a punk,
right.
where in the beginning he didn't. So I kind of wish they just kind of left it as Cisco being a badass this time around.
Right.
I think that would have been more fun.
I like that Iris snapped that photo.
Yeah.
She was ready for that.
Yeah.
She was gangster ready.
That was cool.
She was like, yeah, totally. Ha ha, having a conversation. Click, 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 click.
Right.
Click.
You're not the only one that's fast.
That was great.
That was good.
It was like, I'm going to use you to further my career. So
that was really good.
I think that is going to end up costing her again. I think someone's going to come after her.
Yeah, I think
she's going to become the Peter Parker to Flash.
Right.
Like, the Peter Parker always gets kidnapped because, like, when you take pictures of Spider-Man, you must know him.
Right. Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Little do you know. But, But, like, in this case, it's very much... I'm not going to lie. She had a pretty clear shot of his face. For somebody who's been best friends with him since forever.
Doesn't realize like that.
Real hard for me to believe that she did not recognize him right away.
Right.
I love the fact that his dad figured it out, though.
Oh, man.
That,
you want to talk about emotion?
Whew.
I bet you got you, because I know
that
you...
definitely got me,
you,
man.
And,
got
you
me.
And the dad scenes really get you. But even for me, I was like, wow, Dad. I was like, I wish I was Flash sitting right there.
Right, I'm saying. I was like... Ooh, man, that was good. Somebody must be cutting some onions somewhere.
Right? No, they definitely played. That was really good. I mean, listen, this whole
it was just like this, if I was you know, if the Flash was my son, I would tell him that, and most of all, I would tell him that his father is Brian. And I was like, oh,
right, yeah, absolutely. The whole series, I mean, like I always say every time we do these reviews, is amazing.
Yeah,
and this episode just proves why. One, there's action. Two, there's drama. Three, there's emotional aspects like the dad thing. I mean, there's nothing about this series, and same goes for Arrow, that I can say, oh, they just do one thing too much. No, they do everything, and it works. Yeah. And it really works, and I think this is what Gotham needs to take in effect. This is what Constantine, I feel like, needs a little bit more of, because, which we'll go into, but Constantine needs this. It needs more of not just action, but it needs a little bit like we. And I'll bring that up once again. We'll go. I'm going too far into. But it's just they do an amazing job, and honestly, I just can't. I don't even want the season to end. I just want it to be one giant 10 years of season. Right. Like it's just so.
I think it'll be a great season finale.
I think they're gonna let out a
shot of the Adam suit on one of those. The gurney that the Flash suit is on in the same space, so that means some sort of crossover between them. I think that'll be cool because they've both got the suits. I really hope Adam has shrinking power.
Well, so we're going into Arrow then. We're done with Flash. Let's go to Arrow. So I don't know if any of you have. We might, while we're editing, usually these are quick edits, but while we're talking, we'll put a picture up. But they showed the Adam suit online. They put it up online with Brandon Routh in the suit, and it looks good.
It looks good.
Series suit.
Absolutely.
It looks great, actually. Absolutely. Not just good, it looks great. And I like you said, one, I do hope he has a shrinking power, okay? I hope they figure that out, get it somehow done, whatever. But I can't wait to see him in it. I want to say this. Yeah, that was this episode. I almost thought it was the wrong episode. No, it was this episode. But I love that Felicity basically told Arrow or Oliver that she doesn't want to be his love because they all end up somehow.
Yeah, everyone that you dying. Love ends up getting up, so I don't want to be on that list.
I don't want to be your love.
I don't want to be your love.
And I'm happy with this because I mentioned it last time. I said that I see their relationship more as like a friendship or a brother sister type of relationship. I don't see them as lovers. So I'm actually very happy that the relationship could be over or is done. I hope they keep it that way. I'm very happy with that. I'm trying to remember the episode. I don't remember a lot of that. Why don't I remember the episode? I don't remember a lot of it. I can remember that part.
But
I was happy with that.
Here's the thing. The greatest thing for me was that there was several key things that happened in this episode. You had the riot, and it was the cleanup, right? It was the cleanup. Yes. So it was like, let's clean up the Glades, get rid of the whole brick situation, because that, I think, was not so much dragged out, but I think that was pretty much enough of that. Brick is not really that important, I think, in the grand scheme of things, so I'm glad he was defeated. I'm glad he was put up on display as kind of a, hey, I've been gone, but I'm back, right. And here's my proof.
Right.
See ya.
Yeah, no, absolutely. That part was really, really cool. Now I'm remembering that episode.
I like the fact that Arrow was there, or Canary was out in the streets in public. I like the fact that Sin recognized that it wasn't Sarah and told Captain.
I was just gonna say that. I think that is awesome because I was sick and tired of watching the lie continue, and I really just wanted somebody to be like, "It's not her," and that's what we saw.
And
I'm very happy with.
And she said she was gonna tell her. Laurel said she was gonna tell her. She said, "We gotta talk. We'll talk about that later."
That's true. But obviously,
she said, "Hey, where's Sarah? We'll talk about that later." Yeah.
With everything that was going on.
Yeah. So now I like the fact. I mean, overall, it was good. I don't like the fact that Ted got his ass beat.
Oh, yeah, Wildcat, yes. Well, Brick is
supposed to be... And he said it out loud, too, and it was kind of awkward when he said it. He was like, oh, what mask are you? He's like, Wildcat, boom, boom, boom. And I was like,
Which, it was awkward but cool at the same time.
Right, it was kind of like, yeah. But at the same time, I was like, it was kind of weird that you have to say it, like... Arrow's never said him the arrow.
Right. So it was definitely interesting. Although Brick is supposed to be, as they showed him, he's supposed to be this badass. So Wildcat, and I think almost anybody besides Arrow would have gotten severely messed up by Brick if they went to hand-to-hand combat with this guy. Because that's what they've shown him as.
Sure, yeah. And I mean, I knew he was going to get his ass beat. I just don't like the fact that he did. Like,
yeah.
It's one of those things, like, I wanted Wildcat to be ready for the streets again. Granted, he's a little rusty. He's been out of it. But he
got really beat up. He didn't just get his ass beat. He got beat up so bad that he got, like, he was swelling.
Like, his face was swollen.
When she took the mask off. So, I get they were trying to show that Brick is a guy to be reckoned with. Like, he is a person that is trouble. But, man, did he get his ass beat. Like, I didn't want to say the word, but, like, he really did.
I'm hoping that... I'm hoping he becomes more part of, not necessarily part of the team, but more involved, more accessible.
Right.
You know, he'll be around more during the series.
Right. I hope
that he's around. Because obviously they're building towards a league or society.
I'm glad you just said that because
I feel like they actually might be building towards a society.
Well, here's the thing. So there was an interview, John Diggle. David Ramsey. He said in an interview that it was brought
up. There's conversation. That he might actually be Jon Stewart.
Jon Stewart. That he might be Green Lantern. But here's the thing. So here's part of that interview. And I know this is kind of going away from the episode. But here's the thing from that interview. He also states that in that interview, they are worried they don't see how Green Lantern with the ring and everything fits in this more down to real life world. And I said to myself, I'm like, you can't say that because this world, even though it's not always on Arrow, in this world we have Flash. We have the villains that were in Flash that have meta powers. So there is no reason, none at all, you cannot go the route of Christian Bale and his Batmans, because he specifically didn't want science fiction. He didn't want superpowers.
Where he didn't want science fiction.
Well, no, I'm sorry. Like superpower science fiction. Sure. Like powers or something that's,
sure.
That's real sci-fi, not into this, you know, where more it was like real life. In Arrow, we've already established that's not even a problem. So there's no reason for them to continue to worry about that.
I think it's the same concern you have. So Marvel had, Fox had the concern when they did Phoenix, right?
Right.
Stepping outside of the earthly plane, going outside of that, outside of our sphere, a whole new slew of problems and advantages come into play.
Absolutely.
So you can have awesome scenes in space, and what's your cost? Like a green screen and some wiring.
Right.
And that'll be awesome, but like then is that really the Arrow show? And I think that's kind of where they're getting into it. It's going to be hard to bring that in, because it would have to be an entire episode of just Diggle.
But here's the,
because he would have to go into space.
But here's what I'm saying, though. At that point, if he does become Jon Stewart and he does become the Green Lantern, he has his own show. There's no reason for him to be Arrow's backup or
sidekick.
Because at that point, he's not. So there's no reason to him to be on Arrow. It should be called Green Lantern and just continue the show with him on it. And then sometimes appearing, just like The Flash, in Green Arrow. So there's no reason why they can't do it. You can still keep Oliver's World to be Oliver's World.
Sure.
But when it's time for them to meet up, like they did with Flash, they can do it.
Yeah, and it's going to be one of those things that Jon Stewart being more of... I mean, he's really more of a down-to-earth guy, but at the same time, his wife was of another planet.
Right.
His he's a soldier. I mean, that's why it makes sense that it would be John Diggle. John Diggle could be a cover identity,
right?
Which would make sense again because he has history with Argus, so he could have John Stewart might have been a wanted man, so they made him John Diggle. Sure. And
they can explain that very well.
Yeah, that's easy.
I mean, I know once again we're going outside the episode. I just want to put this to rest. David Ramsey's a badass actor.
Absolutely.
I would love to see him as Jon Stewart. I would love to see. I don't even care if it's on TV or on the big screen. That guy can be the Green Lantern. I would take him all day as Green Lantern. He has the look for Jon Stewart. And I just don't. If they want to do it, do it.
Absolutely.
Don't you worry about anything else.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because
absolutely.
So far, CW and DC, you guys have done nothing but proven that you can still do it. So you got nothing to worry about.
Absolutely.
You know, just make sure you put the right time into it and you do good like you did with Flash. But yeah, all right.
I think the big things around this episode are, so that's what I'm saying, is I like the fact that they had that cleanup. So the brick situation's over.
Yep.
You had that moment where Merlin's the one that stopped Brick. There's no bones.
Yeah.
Let's not
Merlin
make any bones.
Stopped him, period.
Merlin is the one that stopped Brick and almost ended Brick, but Oliver convinced him not to.
Right.
Which gives me just a little bit of hope for Merlin.
Yeah, a little bit. By the way, why can't I think of the guy that plays Merlin? I can't think of his name now. John Barrowman, I believe. He's awesome. I've enjoyed that guy. That guy was on Doctor Who, and he also was on Torchwood. I think he's a great guy. I mean,
sure.
If you ever watch him on Comic-Cons, he's great. But I enjoy Merlin. And to see him change towards more like, oh, I could prevent myself from doing this murder.
Sure.
Like, he didn't have to stop. Arrow Oliver has never been able to convince that guy of anything.
Right.
So he's accepted a long time ago that he's a murderer and that it's okay. So he didn't have to. So to see him, I think it's cool. I think it was the next step
in his evolution.
Yeah,
because
it's the next
You had Thea convinced him to stay in town and not leave.
Right.
So there was that moment where he's like, all right, we're not going to run. We're going to stand and fight. Although I don't like the fact that in the next episode, when he's training her and he's trying to like convince her of the danger at hand,
right.
She's like, "This isn't what I signed up for."
Right.
But like, motherfucker, last episode, yes, you did.
Right.
Like, you know, 2 days ago, you straight up signed up for this when you said, let's make a stand and fight.
Right, right.
You signed up for this specific thing.
Yeah.
So that was kind of annoying as far as Thea's character goes. I heard something for this coming week. That there's going to be something with Chase.
I don't remember watching the preview for that, so I can't really say.
Yeah, but I think this week, because there's that whole Canary thing going to be happening, so I think there's going to be something there. But it's going to be a good episode. I hope they finally tell Lance, because I'm sick of that.
Yeah.
But the other big thing that happened is, I can't think of it now. I like the way that Oliver came back. It was kind of a little plot devicey. It was a little too convenient for me.
Right.
But at the same time, it was perfect.
Yeah, no, I enjoyed it. I was perfectly fine. Like, he couldn't fight, but at the same time, there's no reason why he couldn't show his presence and also...
Which I think rallied the people.
Right, right, exactly.
Gave everybody kind of a second wind.
The biggest thing for me, what I need him to... They need to, because for me, it's going to be on the back of my mind, is he was stabbed, he was dropped, how did he survive? No regular medicine saved him. I don't care.
No.
No regular medicine saved him. So they need to explain that.
Sure.
They need to, if they're not going to do the something needs to be explained on why that guy is alive.
And it's something that's exclusive to her. It's something that Tatsu can do.
Yeah, absolutely. Because if you're telling me you're worried about...
Which, if you remember, I told you she had that sword or something.
Yeah. Absolutely. No, I remember that. So, like I said, they just need to explain it. Because if you're, as a creator of this show, and you talk about how you're worried of going to the paranormal instead of sticking to the real world, well, that doesn't explain Oliver's alive.
Yeah,
because
he dropped at least 50 feet.
I'm saying he dropped
under rock,
and he got stabbed through the center, almost through the center of his of his torso. So he is not alive in the normal world. period. And yeah. It took some time, not only that, but it took some time to get to him, his buddy to get to him, and to drag him all the way to that place. So, I don't care how you put it, you just need to explain why he's, how he's alive.
Yeah, something needs to be, because he brought him there dead.
Yeah.
Like, there's no question about...
Yeah, he was dead.
There's no question about the fact, like, he wasn't, like, still alive.
No, he was dead.
Like, no, he was dead, and she brought him back.
Absolutely.
So, something that she has and has access to...
I need an explanation.
They need to talk about that, and...
And listen, we got time. We still have definitely a few more episodes. At least 10 or 9?
No.
Because we're on 13, right? They've done 22 to 24. All the seasons so far
That's
have been
true,
22
yeah.
to 24.
Wow, yeah.
So we have at least 9 episodes to go. So that being said, you have 9 episodes to tell me a 5-minute spiel on why that guy's alive.
Yeah, 5 minutes. That's all I need. I don't need a whole episode.
I don't need a whole episode. I just need 5 minutes. Hey, listen, I can do this. Cool. Go on. Next part of the story.
Yeah.
Like, I don't need more than that. I do not need it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but overall, Flash, Arrow.
It was great. Amazing. It was great. There was, I think the Arrow episode was definitely key. There was a lot of things that happened that had to happen. And I think there's going to be good stuff coming up. I'm excited for this week because...
I'm just excited for the future episodes. I'm excited for both of them.
There was one other thing that I'll talk about. You were talking about Comic-Cons. He was at Dallas... and I didn't watch the whole video, but
he was John Barrowman was there.
He was talking about
him, Ramsey. So Oliver or Stephen Amell, David Ramsey, and John Barrowman went together to the.
And they were talking about that there might be a name change as well as a costume change. So he was talking about he might become Green Arrow. Sooner than later.
I'm okay
with
the name change because I would like to hear Green Arrow. I would like.
I'm glad they went from
the Hood.
The Hood
to Arrow, which is good.
Yeah.
But now I wouldn't mind hearing Green Arrow. I don't necessarily care for a costume change because the only thing that I would like them to change when it comes down to the costume is that little bit here. Is not working. That's Oliver Queen.
It's funny because they addressed that this episode. Roy was talking to Lance, and Lance is like, Roy, what do you want? And he's like, how do you know? He's like, I don't care. You know, it's a little.
He's like, I've seen you run around in a red hoodie. You don't think just a little mask over your like so it has to. There's no way. So that being said, there's no way that Detective.
Hey, and 5 minutes, he's right in front of Lance, and I'm like, how do you not?
How do you
it's
not?
Impossible.
It's impossible to not figure out that
this is Oliver Queen.
This is Oliver Queen. Like,
so something needs to change.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Something needs to change. There needs to be more of a under the hood disguise because overall, the costume works.
It looks like
Green Arrow.
Sure.
Makes sense to me. It's just really more on the face, and he does wear gloves, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So otherwise, yeah, just really the face. Like, there's no way. Because they have the voice changer, makes sense. So there's no way that they won't. There's no way somebody cannot be like, "Oh, that's not Oliver Queen."
Right.
What are you talking about?
Well, that's the thing is, I want them to address that, and I want them if they're gonna do a costume change, I'm cool with that because so far all the costumes they've done on both these shows have been great. So I really have no problem with they.
Yeah, no, absolutely. The costumes have been great.
What I think needs to happen is Palmer's plan to change it to Star City needs to happen.
Yep.
So it needs to become Star City.
Yep.
And then once it's Star City, it can be Green Arrow.
Yep.
Because I think that just kind of brings it all together and makes it real nice and smooth.
I agree. Absolutely.
Because they did call him Arsenal this time, and it was great.
It was great.
Although it was kind of funny because like Arsenal was like, are you guys just picking names out of a hat?
Yeah, but it's great. I like it. But it was great though. That little. What are you guys just picking names out of a hat? It's great though. It was a good line. But. No, I like it. I think I just can't wait to see Adam be Adam. I can't wait for him to get his own show. And I can't wait to see...
Yeah, because they were talking about Palmer having his own show, but
yeah,
I don't know how I feel about that.
I'm okay with it. It makes perfect sense. Oliver needs to be Oliver. That needs to be his show.
Sure.
Adam needs to have his own show. I'm perfectly
fine. It's just going to be like... This is going to be the CW week. The DC week.
Because here's the thing. I can accept... Arrow, Canary, and Arsenal being in one show. I can accept that because they work together.
That's kind of a family.
You know
yeah.
what I'm saying?
That's
they work together.
Unit.
Where with Adam, I feel like that would be too much.
It'd be too much, but here's the thing. If they're going to be in the same city, it's...
Yeah, well, that's true, but
that's
it all
depends.
But it, is Adam supposed to be in Star City, though? No. So that's what I'm trying to say. If they maybe move him, if Oliver comes back, moves, takes over.
I mean, I suppose that's a possibility, yeah. But it's just, it's one of those things that, I like the fact that that the excuse that he had for being gone was, oh, I had to visit a friend in Bloodhaven, which is another throw to Nightwing.
Sure, absolutely.
And he's like, I had to visit a friend in Bloodhaven. I spent the last week in prison. And I was like, what?
But it's great, though. It was great. Cause
she's like, I thought those days were behind
me. She's like, so did I. But I guess, you know, you get some drinks in
you. But you know what? It was one of those things that it was plausible.
Yeah, absolutely.
That even the most changed person is going to have that moment of slip.
Yeah.
He's going to slip for a minute. And he's going to do some stupid shit. And he's going to be like...
And nobody would die.
They're like, it took you 4 years to slip? You have done excellent.
Right?
Congratulations, let's move on.
Right, like, oh, exactly.
A week in prison? You didn't kill nobody? Shit. You're fine.
You're fine. No, it was a great episode. I honestly, there's not really much. Guys, if you don't watch Flash or Arrow, just watch Flash and Arrow.
Yeah, seriously.
There's really no reason why not. We got one more, right?
Constantine. Which I just finished watching.
And what did you think about it?
I liked it. There was a little more emotion. There was a little more about John, how he is, who he is, how he deals with the day-to-day. I loved the fact that Manny was human for a day, which
I
was hilarious.
I loved seeing the angel Manny as a human. I loved that Zed was able to see him at the end. I love that she
he gave that to her.
Right, which I also love that she realized that the doctor standing in front of her was Manny and wasn't the doctor. The episode was just really good, and I think what brought it together, I think why I enjoyed it, was due to Manny. The fact that he was involved more and that he was in this episode.
There was more of a sounding board. Because I think what it comes down to is Manny is such a different personality from John, that it's good to have that play.
Yeah,
that back and forth
between
different personalities is what I think makes a good show.
I agree.
So when it's Chaz and John,
I mean,
Chaz is not that different
right,
from John. He's
right.
Kind of in it for the long haul. And you know, he was like, oh, you're going to stab me in my leg? Cool, I guess. Whatever. That shit hurts, but like, cool.
Cool, I'll
And then he was like, oh, you want me to test drive this, you know, Heart of Darkness? Cool, I guess. You know,
yeah.
Like, he's in it, you know, I want to do this crazy thing.
I mean, don't get me wrong.
He
looks at him like, are you insane? But, all right, fine.
Yeah, it's got to be done. I've got lives to spare. So he's kind of in that position of like, whatever, I'm going to do whatever needs to be done.
Here's my question to you. Do you like the fact that they literally just got rid of the map and they're literally removing the fact that she was involved in this story at all?
I was a little mad.
I was waiting to hear that from him because he always brings up, so like,
was,
I know where the blood.
He was like, let me check on this crime map. He was like, whoosh. I was like, oh, that's a way to deal with that. That's a way to not have to think about that.
It's like, oh, guess what? You're not gonna be bringing up that question again.
But here's the thing. Now we're going with no plan. We're not going in any direction because that was kind of the whole thing. It was kind of like a countrywide tour.
Sure,
but he
also did say use Zed, use her visions, exploit.
Sure.
So she might be getting more of a bump in how she uses her power and all that.
Yeah, and that's the other thing is he kind of flat out told her that her visions are divine.
Yeah,
which is cool. I thought that was cool.
Yeah,
it kind of removes that self doubt from her, gives her a little more confidence.
Because there definitely was self doubt. Because for the whole time I'm thinking, I'm like, really, a tumor in the head is doing all this? It's like, you're gonna go that route? Yeah. All right.
Bye.
That's not that cheap.
What?
PNY Optima, 240 gig for 167. That's not that cheap.
240? No, that's not cheap.
Come on, New Wave. That's not a shocker. There's nothing shocking about that.
They're at $100 nowadays.
Seriously. Anyway.
So back to the thing. So the tumor.
It just didn't make sense.
It didn't make sense to me. I'm like, you're really going to play off the tumor to being...
Yeah, I was like, oh, maybe it's a tumor. And I was like, what?
Right. And then Constantine telling Manny to heal her.
I liked that moment.
But here's my question. I mean, I understand he doesn't want to play with Faith. Obviously, it's fate for her to have that tumor. So, I mean, if he puts, you know, as an angel, if he puts his... you know, if he has the ability to heal, if he puts his tries to go into that and remove it, he's playing with faith, which I think as an angel he wouldn't want to do. But at the same time, if you're telling this woman that she has divine powers,
but he hadn't gotten to that point yet. You know, that's the thing. She had to kind of come to that realization on her own.
Sure.
And I think that really was what that was about. What I really liked about that moment when he asked him is he had that real moment of emotion, which right. I thought was great.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
I thought that was great for John to show that. Like, those little few moments that he's done, that kind of really emotional, like, I really care about this person, fix this.
Well, the previous...
Or what do I need to do to fix
absolutely.
This?
Absolutely. Well,
it was like, you have... That's really good to see for that character.
Well, yeah, absolutely. And I think, like, seeing the emotion thing, I don't think we talked about it in the last one. For the previous episode where she says, I saw your mom, and she said, I thought that was pretty intense emotionally, so that was pretty cool too. I'm very happy to see them tossing that in, but I hope they keep Manny in more. I think it really worked, and it would
it's gonna
work really good if they continue to keep him. I feel like, yes, there's already three actors in this show, and you could technically say they're all different types of people, but I feel like Manny brings that different in.
I love the fact that 20 minutes after becoming a human...
He gets laid.
He got laid. I was like, you've been around since the dawn of time, and you just
and
got laid.
I love
laid.
His reaction, though.
He
I
was like, now. Reaction. And he's like, now.
Yeah, like, that was awesome. I was dying.
Oh, man. That was so good.
I really hope...
And he was like, here?
I really hope they bring him in more. I think that's going to make the difference that I'm looking for.
I think what they're going to end up playing is, I think it's going to have to happen. I think he's going to have a fall from grace because he can't be active. That's the thing. That's kind of his rule.
Right.
No, their rule right. for him is that he can't be an active part of the whole thing. And I think he's going to meddle one too many times. He's going to get kicked out, but he's going to get kicked out maybe with some powers.
Right. And I'm okay with that.
And I'm cool with that, because then he'll have that knowledge base.
Sure.
You know, he won't have the entirety of heaven's knowledge, but he'll have a he's been around since the dawn of time.
So he has
He's got some information.
But yeah, I like to see him more, period. That's all I'm... The episode was good. I enjoyed it. I loved...
Absolutely.
Like I said, Manny being in there and showing different character like that, and just the little things he experienced... seeing him as an angel kicking, you know, destroying the evil out of that guy.
That was awesome. I like that. That was a great moment of redemption. He comes down and says, you know what I've noticed also? It's kind of a non sequitur, but his wings are dark.
Yeah. I think that's just how it is. I think there's nothing to that.
Well, because you had the one chick that had black wings.
But hers were straight black. His aren't, like, black. His are right. Roundish. So I think that's just a...
Just kind of how they designed
him. Yeah, just how they decided to go with instead of, like, pure white.
Right.
He's clearly a good angel.
Right. Yeah. Well, I just mean like, I think it might... I don't necessarily mean going evil. I just think he might be falling out of grace a little bit just because he's taking more of an active role, I think.
But they've always shown them with those wings, so yeah. There's really no explaining. I think that's just how it is.
Sure.
But yeah, overall, I enjoyed the episode. It was a good episode. I can't wait to see the final episode because there was, like, a... the preview / commercial afterwards, like, for an epic season finale, so it better be epic, because if you're going to say it's going to be an epic season finale...
Is the season finale next week?
Yeah, 13, episode 13.
Dang.
So that's it. So we'll see. Constantine's going to end here for us soon.
So Constantine will end, so we'll have one less show to talk about in 2 weeks.
But then we'll add in Walking Dead and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
But Agent Carter's finishing in
that's true.
3 weeks, so...
That's true. But yeah, that's really it for our reviews. I really don't have much else to say about Constantine. I enjoyed it. I hope they keep Manny around. Not like, I mean
it's the one episode left, so...
I mean, obviously they're going to keep him around, but I hope he's involved more throughout here. If they keep the show and they keep going with it, I hope he's still around with more airtime, because it looks like that's what's going to work.
Well, here's the thing. I watched it on the NBC website, and what I think, and I think this is... part of the reason why NBC cut it to 13 episodes, I think they are really trying to figure out a good layout of shows.
Well, the thing is Grimm is working out so well for them, and they're trying to figure out how to put something together with Grimm.
That's on NBC?
Yeah.
Really?
Grimm is really good, by the way.
Because they have Grimm, and they have Once Upon a Time.
Right.
Those are the only shows they have.
Right.
But they have that new show, which is based on Once Upon a Time.
Right.
So they have three really good shows, and I'm looking at all the other stuff, I'm like, literally things I've never heard of.
Yeah, there's...
And I'm kind of looking at it, and I'm like, man, like, even on ABC, there's so many shows that I've heard of. Even though if I don't watch them, I've heard of them. I've heard of them, and I've heard of people talking about them.
Right.
So... Like, the only thing I saw, that they had a commercial for Chicago Fire, and I was like, okay, like, I know that show.
Right.
But it's just, like, I feel it's Chicago Fire. Their target audience is, I think, very different from, like, ABC or CW, so that I think they're trying to bring in some of those...
And they're
trying to fight for those spots, because here's the thing. It's, like, Agent Carter and Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. go up against one of the highest-rated shows of all fucking time. They go up against NCIS. And... Because Agents Carter and Flash are the same night. I think they're at different times, though.
That's possible.
Because they're on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Is Flash on Tuesday or is Arrow on Tuesday? Well, whatever.
Yeah, Flash is before Arrow, so I think Flash is on Tuesday.
So, Agent Carter... So, those two shows go up against NCIS, which is literally... Well, I think NCIS and NCIS New Orleans, which is also, even though it's a new show and not as good, I think, but it's... They're still hugely rated. They're hugely successful. NCIS is on its, like, 14th season or something stupid. I mean, they've been around for ages. So it's one of those things. It's like SVU. Like, SVU can never bet against SVU. Like, SVU's always going to be on. You know, I'm gonna be an old man at, you know, Law and Order, SVU.
Right.
But the thing about that is that you have all these slots really tightly packed. So for NBC to put in another show... Like, they have their slot with Grimm, and it's succeeding. Grimm is taking that time. It's making its viewership.
Well, that's the thing. They're trying... That's specifically what they said. They said they don't want to cancel Constantine.
And Friday is a hard spot to fight in.
Well, that's what they're saying.
Because there's not
they're
a lot of shows
they're trying to,
fight with. To
get somebody that's equivalent to Grimm so he can have that back-to-back rating. So, you know, whoever's watching, they can have it back-to-back. So they're trying to just align it correctly with Grimm.
Sure.
Now, there's no reason why Constantine wouldn't be able to align with Grimm, because Grimm is literally all about being able to see werewolves and vampires and all this and that. So they just don't call him that. They call him other things. But Grimm is a great show. It Constantine should be able to be in front or after that. And it's just, once again, Constantine needs something to grip the audience, and I think Manny's gonna help out with that. So if they keep him more, like they did with this episode, it'll definitely work out.
Well, I think it's gonna be interesting either way.
I just can't wait to see the finale, just to see how epic it is.
I hope not knowing if, because they still haven't renewed it, so not knowing if there's gonna be a season two.
Then they should end it.
It should be a really good ending.
It should be an ending to the point where either you can end a series with that or you can continue.
Yeah, because I think it's one of those things that they can't have the big fight with La Brujeria,
right?
Because
no.
That would have been the 22 episode season.
Yeah, that shouldn't.
So that's going to be interesting if they try to have that fight, and I don't think you can succeed, because really right now we're still kind of in that information gathering stage,
right.
Like in a war, because that's he keeps talking about it. You know, a war is on. Well, in a war, you can't win at the information gathering
right.
stage. You know, your intel guys don't win the fight. You know, the fight, the battle is won on the field. So right now, they're still trying to figure out what is all going on.
Right.
Like, they kind of got the gist of what they want to do, but how they're going to do it, you know, where, all that stuff. You know, I kind of hope it's a two-hour finale. I don't think it is, but...
It's got to be pretty good, because if they had...
If it ends poorly,
then it's over. But if they end okay, even then, you're up and down on if it's going to continue or not.
Right.
So.
And we're going to kind of get the same flavor show in our reviews with iZombie coming out. It's going to be a half season as well. This starts in March.
Yeah.
So I'm watching... They call it a mid-season show, and I'm like, March is not the mid-season.
Right.
Like, I don't know how you count that,
right.
But that's not the mid-season.
Yeah. But that's... Is there anything else for Constantine?
No. Overall, it was a good show, a good episode, and I think I'm excited to see you next week.
Yeah, same here. So that's it, guys.
That's pretty much it. Look for our review next week with The Walking Dead.
The Walking Dead.
Which,
I'm excited.
That was last night.
We gotta watch that.
Well, I'm watching that tonight.
We should watch together. Because we don't watch these shows together, guys.
Yeah, we watch them separately.
Yeah.
Well, the wife wants to see it.
Well, if we get her.
Forget her, okay. That ends poorly for me. But, But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Appreciate it. Yep. If you liked it, like, subscribe, check out T3GTech.com. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, all that good stuff. And if you have any comments, thoughts on these shows, please let us know. We'd love to have that discussion.
Definitely.
You know, we're big nerds, man. We just like to talk about this stuff. We're big film fans, show fans.
We're just trying to keep it to a minimum because we can always go on and on.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, we've already gone on. So we're trying to limit it.
Yeah, that's it, guys. So we'll, like you said, just leave some thoughts in the comments, and we'll see you guys next time.
That's it.